fourth question first of this is e to the power of x. We can show that this function either having minimum nor maximum, either minimum nor maximum value. Okay. I mean, just observe the graph. This graph will be, if it is tends to plus infinity, it will be increased. If it is tends to minus infinity, it will be decreasing. But we don't know particular value of a particular maximum value at a particular point, and we don't know particular minimum value at particular x value. We don't know y value. What is y value? Maximum value of y? No, we don't know. So according to the graph, it does not have any minimum or any maximum. So mathematically, how to write? So let us take one, differentiate with respect to f dash of x is equal to e power. Now, f dash of x is equating to 0, e power x equal to 0. This is not possible. Possible because of e power x should not equal to 0. For every x value belongs to R. For every x belongs to R, e to the power of x should not 0. But here we got equal to 0. Is it possible? Take any x value, it should not equal to 0, but here we got 0, which is complex. So what we can write here? The function neither having minimum nor maximum. Okay, exponential function can never assume 0 for any x value. We never assume that for any x value it is 0. Right? So what is the second one? Log x is given. What shall we write here? Therefore, then here we write therefore this does not exist any x belongs to R such that f dash of x is equal to 0. And f of x neither having minimum nor maximum. Otherwise, and f of x does not have minimum or maximum. This will be right, it's not a problem, but we should know the condition here, whether it is equal to 0 or not. And log x. Observe the f of x is equal to log x. What is the graph of log x? Log x does not have any minimum or any maximum value. Look at here. This is the graph, so there is no minimum value, there is no maximum value. There is no particular minimum value, it will be tends to minus infinity. It will be tends to plus infinity. Okay. So f of x is equal to log x. Yeah, differentiate that log x. Look at here, f dash of the g of x, g dash of x, it's 1 by x. Now, g dash of x is equal to 0, nothing but 1 by x is equal to 0. Is it possible again? Is it exist? What is the domain? So they will give question like this, but we should know the domain. Domain nothing but x value. Look at here, what is the domain here? Domain value or domain is x value here belongs to, x is belongs to open interval 0 to infinity. Because I say the log 0 undefined, so that we can take more than 0, except 0. 0 to infinite. Log does not exist for negative value of x. For this, here x is greater than 0. X is should be, the meaning is x is should be greater than 0. But whenever x is greater than 0, x is greater than 0, if 1 by x becomes 0? No, it's not possible, because x greater than 0 means 1 by x always should not equal to 0, will be, but we got equal to 0. So, this is not possible for any, write on as it is. There doesn't exist any x belongs to, x belongs to 0 to infinite, f dash of x is equal to 0, nothing but g dash of x is equal to 0, like this. So, like this, therefore, that does not exist any x value, does not exist any x belongs to domain 0 to infinite such that f g dash of x should be equal to 0, and g of x does not have maximum or minimum that we have. Third subdivision, k of x is given. K of x is equal to h of x. H of x is equal to x cube plus x square plus x plus 1. Now, we can show that this function neither have minimum nor maximum. So what should we do here? First, h dash of x. We have to write each and every point here. Let us see equation. Differentiate with respect to x on both sides. Like that, we can write the procedure. So derivative is 3x square plus 2x plus 1 plus 0. X cube is 3x square. X square is 2x. X is 1. 1 is 0. And h dash of x equating to 0, nothing but 3x square plus 2x plus 1 equating to 0. Yeah, 3 into 1, 3. Factors are easily factors. What are the factors of this quadratic equation? Anyone?
Sir, it will come as imaginary values.
We'll get imaginary. So, how to check whether the roots are imaginary or not? Okay, anyway, find roots. Minus b plus r minus root over b square minus 4ac by 2a formula. So, comparing a square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. A value is 3, b value is 2. A value 3, b value 2, c value 1. So, final x is equal to minus b. Minus 2 plus r minus root over b square. B square means 2 square. 4a. A value is 3. C value is 1 by 2a. 2a. A value is 3. So I compared with x square, bx plus c. After that, this is clearly quadratic equation. So this is clearly formula minus b plus or minus root over b square minus 4ac by 2a. So finally we got here minus 2 s r minus 4 minus 12 by 6. So x is equal to, we got minus 2 s r minus 4 minus 12 is root minus 8 by 6. So minus 2, this can be written as 2 minus 2. See, 8 can be written as 4 into minus 2. 4 into minus 2, 4 you can take outside. So no need to simplify, we will write directly as imaginary. So if it is 4 marks question, you can expand. 2 is common. 2 is common, minus 1 plus or minus. Root over minus 2 means root 2i. Okay, by 6. So finally, this is doesn't belong to real number. So whenever x is a real number, then only we can find maxima and minima. So maxima, minima, we cannot find for imaginary value. Okay, remember that this is not belongs to us. Therefore, f of x, there doesn't exist, does not exist, exists to minima or maxima for imaginary value. Imaginary value, hence the function does not have minima or maxima. Or hence f of x neither have minimum nor maximum, like that. In each question, there are many sub-results are there. In question number 5, find the absolute maximum value. Absolute maximum or local maximum? Absolute minimum, local minimum. I already explained the concept. Okay, for example, the curve may be like this. See here, what are the local maximum? This is local maximum, local maximum, local maximum, local maximum. Here local maximum. Local minimum, this is local minimum, this is local minimum, this is local minimum, local minimum. So, if you observe here, this is local minima, this is local maxima. See, local maxima also less than to local minima. Observe, this is minima, local minima, this is local maxima. So for coming to local maxima and local minima, the local minima may be more than the value of local maxima also sometimes, but whereas absolute maxima and absolute minima, so these are the local maximum among this, whatever the highest value, whatever the greatest and highest value of the function, we can consider as absolute maximum. This is absolute maximum. What is absolute minimum? This is absolute minimum. So there are many local minimum will be there. Among this, whatever the value having least value, then that is called absolute minimum. Okay? So find all local maximum, all local minimum, among that check the value. Whatever the highest value is there, that is absolute maximum. Whatever the least value is there, that is absolute minimum. Procedure will be same. Take f of x, find f dash of x, e tending to 0 will get x value. That x value substitute f double dash. Concept will be same. The first question is, find absolute maximum, absolute minimum. The first sub-reason is, f of x, x cube, and x belongs to minus 2 to 2. Yeah, what do you observe here? Actually, we discussed that f of x is equal to x cube neither having maxima nor minima. Okay, already we have seen that this is a graph. It will move to plus infinite, it will move to minus infinite. So that there is no maximum, there is no minimum. Even observe here, even f of x is x cube, f dash of x is 3x square, and equating to 0, we get x is equal to 0. Equating to 0 means x is equal to 0. Find f double dash of x. F double dash of x value is, again, this value is like 3, 6, x. Substitute this x is equal to 0 here, yes, we get 0. F double dash of x, we got 0. 0 nothing but 0 is not greater than 0, not less than 0. When when they don't give particular interval. Particular interval is not given so that we can say that from minus infinity to plus infinity, x cube does not have any maximum, any minimum, but interval is given. From where to where? Minus 2 to plus 2. We can draw the lines here. See, the curve having, from the graph, the curve having some maximum value, the curve having some minimum value. So we need to find both the values. So this is the difference between interval is given, particular interval is given, interval is not given. Like, okay, the solution says differentiate with respect to x on both sides, so 3x6. After that, f dash of x equating to 0, then f dash of x value is 3x² equating to 0. So x² is equal to 0, x is equal to 0. If 0 is belongs to, first of all we have to check that it is belongs to given interval or not. That is important. And also check that whether the given interval is open interval or closed interval. If it is open interval, again there is no maximum, there is no minimum. We can't say that. There will be a maximum, but we can't say if it is open interval. But closed interval means we can consider end points also. We can take end points also. So look at it. This is clearly 0 is belongs to minus 2 to plus 2, 0 will be here. So these are the x values. Now, how many x values are there finally? X values are minus 2 to 2, and here x we got 0 also. So that we can check the function value. Here no need to find the f double dash of, no need to find. Okay, because minus 2 is given, 2 is also belongs to x value. Therefore, x is equal to minus 2, 0, 2. Minimum least value of x, highest value of x, we got 0 also. Even we can take the values like between all these values, like we can take like minus 1 also we can take, not an issue. Okay, so finally I am taking maximum, minimum and whatever the x value. At these 3 points I want to take f of it. First, at minimum, at x is equal to minus 2, f of minus 2 is value is minus 2 cubed, that is minus 8. Next, at x is equal to 0, second value, at x is equal to 0, f of 0, this value is substituting given one, 0 cubed, that is 0. Finally, at x is equal to plus 2, f of 2 is equal to 2 cubed, that is 8. So, after getting x values, these x values directly can substitute in given one. See, here we got different values. So what is the, among these three values, what is the highest value and what is the least value? Highest value is absolute. Least value is absolute minimum. Highest value is absolute maximum. Therefore, the maximum value is maximum value of given function f of x is 8. When maximum value is 8, when x is equal to 2, then what will we write? And the minimum value of f of x is minus 8 when x is equal to minus 2. So we cannot consider at 0 because 0 is not maximum value, not minimum value. So highest value is 8, so maximum value 8. So maximum value 8 when x is equal to point of maximum is 2. Minimum value minus 8, point of minimum is minus. Thank you. So in all these questions, they give a closed interval. Particular interval is given. In that particular interval, we need to check maximum and minimum. If they don't give interval, means minus infinite to plus. Yeah, subdivision B, f of x is equal to same sin x plus cos x, but here they give an interval, closed interval 0 to 5. Nothing but we can take x value 0, x value 5, two values are given already. We need to find another point, like let us take this equation one. What is the pressure? Find it. Double dash f dash of x, sin x derivative, cos x derivative minus x. After that, f dash of x is equating to 0. F dash of x equating to 0 means cos x minus sin x is equal to 0. Cos x is equal to sin x. Nothing but dividing with cos x on both sides. So that is nothing but 1 is equal to tan x. Tan x is equal to 1. Now, 0 to 181 can be written as tan pi by 4. So finally, tan x is equal to tan 45. 45 value 1. So get here, x is equal to pi by 4. Is pi by 4 clearly belongs to 0 to 5? Is there any, there exists any value of x tan is 1? Third quadrant. Again, third quadrant we get plus 1, but they given up to second quadrant 1. 0 to 180 means up to second quadrant. But we don't have to take any value in third quadrant. So tan is plus 1. Plus 1 means first quadrant, third quadrant. So they give an interval 0 to 180. So only one value exists, that is 45. I said clearly among all these exercises in this applications of derivative, this maximum and minimum is very important compared to tangents and normal, increasing, decreasing. Okay. And even in approximation, like 6.4 is approximation. So we have to practice every day. Then sending some assignment question. I don't know how many are doing that assignment. Okay. I said yesterday complete 6.1, 6.2. Okay, that is also, I don't know how many have completed. Because no one has asking any doubts to me. I hope so everyone completed. My sincere suggestion is, you must practice mathematics every day, especially for NEET students. Because for JE students, again we are revising the concept in objective classes. But whereas NEET, you must be practiced every day. Now it's looking like okay, we understand, but if you not practice that after 1 week, after 10 days, again it's looking like very new. Okay. So tomorrow on Monday, I said till Monday you have to complete class work. I said clearly, whatever you practice the problem, the same question, without looking at the question, you can write in your class. Just to practice. Any doubts here till this question? See, we got x value. So finally, we got 3 x values. So what are the x values? So x is equal to 1 is 0. So x is equal to 0, pi by 4 and pi. Because closed interval, so consider end points also. X is equal to 0, already pi, they given already. So by equating to 0, we got x is equal to pi by 4. Okay, only one value between these two values because it is equal to 1. So pi by 4 is belongs to given interval. So 0, pi by 4, yes, pi. Now we can find the f of value. What if at x is equal to 0? What is f of 0? All of you find at x is equal to pi by 4. At x is equal to pi by 4, what is f of pi by 4? At x is equal to pi. What is f of pi? Just tell me. Among three, these three values, whatever the highest value, that is max. Whatever the least value, that is max. Yes? Hello? Somebody asking some doubts. Because if you practice every day, definitely you get center mark, everyone. So what is f of 0 value? Sin 0 plus cos 0. 1. Substitute here, given function. Pi by 4, sin 45, 1 by root 2 plus cos 45, 1 by root 2. That is root 2. Sin 180 sin f of 180 sin 180 0 cos 180 is minus. So maximum value is root 2 and minimum value is minus. Okay. So note it down and you can attend for another class. If you have any doubt, you can okay, I'm ending the meeting.